provide trainings for human rights defenders on how to communicate with media. And also, as I mentioned, we are monitoring and documentation of the immigration to collect information and prepare different reports and spread misinformation for different audiences. Together with our colleagues from Russia, we are running a human rights field mission in Crimea that is only one monitoring mission that works on a permanent, more or less permanent base on Crimean Peninsula. So it's, in short, maybe I just add one moment that we are working also on promoting the future reforms of legislation in sphere of human rights.
Мы издаем вот этот журнал как один из проектов.
I'm a chief editor of a journal called DOSH. This is what we do, this is our work.
Здесь мы пишем о проблемах нарушения прав человека.
In that journal we write about issues regarding human rights violations.
О проблемах молодежи.
About youth problems.
Здравоохранения, экологии.
About health, ecology.
Которые не находят отражения в официальной прессе.
That is the information that is not to be found in official mass media.
Дело в том, что официальная пресса в республиках Северного Кавказа освещает только сугубо официальные события. Mm-hmm.
Because the official mass media in the Caucasus, in North Caucasus, they only cover all that has to do with the governmental issues.
Они рассказывают о том, какие хорошие руководители республики, власти.
They tell how wonderful the leaders of their countries are.
Как много они делают для людей.
How much they do for their people, for the population of their countries.
А все остальные проблемы людей остаются за кадром.
While all the problems that are too many people, they remain on the other side.
Вот мы пишем в журнале о том, какие проблемы есть у людей в разных сферах их жизни.
That's why in our journal we tell about situations for these people in different spheres of their lives.
В Чечне, Ингушетии, Дагестане, Кабардино-Балкарии, Карачаево-Черкесии.
In Чечня, Ингушетия, Дагестан, Кабардино-Балкария и Черкесия.
Мы также пишем о том, о проблемах ксенофобии в России.
We also write about issues regarding xenophobia in Russia.
О конкретных случаях, которые происходят в отношении кавказцев в остальной России.
And more specific cases regarding hate against people from Caucasus in Russia.
О пытках, которые являются серьезной проблемой против кавказцев в российских тюрьмах тоже.
Also we write about torture against people from Caucasus that happens in Russian prisons.
Это журнал ДОШ, но у нас есть, кроме этого, еще разные проекты, например, социологические опросы.
This is one of the programs we have. This is journal ДОШ, and we also have some social
opinion polling.
В России нет выборов руководителей регионов.
In Russia there are no elections for regional leadership.
Да. И нет референдума.
There's no referendums.
И наши социологические исследования позволяют выявить мнение, общественное мнение по различным актуальным проблемам.
In our opinion polling stage help to highlight the meaning of people.
Также мы проводим тренинги и семинары для молодых журналистов.
We also do trainings and seminars for youth journalists.
В том числе и для будущих журналистов, студентов. Вот некоторые да, я думаю. У нас есть еще один новый проект.
We also have another project, but I think,
Да. Это совместный с организацией
Together
ИНИ, СИНТЕМ,
проект This is another project we have. This is another journal. It's called Women's Word in Russian. It's only published in Russian for now.
Проблема, о которых Инна сейчас иллюстративно вам рассказывала.
The problems that Inna told you just a while ago.
Мы основные эти проблемы пытаемся отразить в журнале.
Most of these problems we're trying to illustrate in our journal.
Это такой продукт нашей совместной деятельности, нашего очень успешного взаимодействия.
It's a cooperation, it's part of our cooperation that we have, which is a very successful one.
И на основе этого журнала теперь сложился, сформировался дискуссионный клуб.
And on the basis of this journal we have a discussion.
Он называется Диалог.
Called Dialogue.
И в этот журнал в основном пишут непрофессиональные журналисты.
And in this journal we publish non-journals, so everyone can contribute to it.
В основном женщины-активистки и просто женщины пишут свои истории, разные проблемы, и мы их только редактируем немножко и предоставляем эту возможность, эту площадку для того, чтобы они рассказывали об этом сами.
Most of them are maybe some activists, but mainly just regular women who raise the issues that they worry about, and we just edit the text and publish it in the magazine.
Вот.
Yeah. So we have both in Russian and in English. So it's just, you know, when you're done, maybe just try to read some because it's very interesting.
For me and probably most of the West. The Russian invasion of Crimea and sort of the aggressive stance came as a total shock and a surprise. Now, I was wondering how it felt for you from your side. Was it a tipping point, or was it more of a was it part of a longer trend towards aggression?
I want to start my story referring to the 90s, in 1993, Ukraine signed the so-called Budapest Memorandum. It means before that Ukraine was a nuclear weapon country. After the USSR collapsed, we had a lot of nuclear weapon in our country. So this Budapest Memorandum meant that Ukraine voluntarily refuses from its nuclear weapon and destroys it. So Ukraine will not be anymore this nuclear weapon country. And this is the only case in the world that a country that had nuclear weapon refused from it. And the Budapest Memorandum signed by three countries, from one side Ukraine, from another side Russian Federation, United States and Great Britain, meant that Ukraine refuses from the nuclear weapon, and these three countries guarantee Ukraine its sovereignty. So nobody will attack Ukraine or kept the part of it. And in 20 years we see the situation when one of these three countries occupied and annexed the territory of Ukraine, and this is the fact that effects that strikes me a lot is that Anna mentioned in last 60 years the first case when the country, a neighboring country, not only occupied but legally, like it's not legal of course, but tried to annex the territory, legalize annexation and to destroy all the international law and standards.